My name's Luke Stoltman. I'm 35 years old, born in Invergordon in the Highlands of Scotland, and I've lived here all my life. I grew up here, and it's a small town, about 7,000 people. So to be competing in front of 10,000 people is pretty intense at the moment. You know, it's to think that a guy from the Highlands of Scotland is effectively going to be pressing today the heaviest log press ever lifted, which is pretty cool. It's something that I've sought out to do for a couple of years now, thought that the possibilities was there since I first pressed that 200 kilo log. So now we're stepping up a notch and we're going to be hitting 230 kilos today, which is pretty frightening, to say the least. The term strength or being strong was kind of from a young age. I remember the primary school that I went to, Newmore Primary, there was always a bit of kind of rivalry in the playground, you know, who could pick up the heaviest tyre, or, you know, trying to pick up cars and stuff like that, just trying to show off. You know, that's really kind of what installed my kind of strength journey, I think. And then going forward into the academy where I went to, the high school, and again there was that rivalry with everyone there. It was who was the strongest, who was the fastest, whatever. And it turned out, you know, I was always quite strong. I really got a buzz from being able to lift more than my friends. I wasn't necessarily the best academically. I kind of had a bit of a problem with, you know, that authority. The teachers kind of maybe didn't see eye to eye with them, which wasn't the best. But certainly the strength, that was always a fundamental factor for me. And anyone that was strong, I automatically gave them my respect. You know, it was one of those things, the stronger you are as a person, I really kind of respected that. And looking to my dad, my grandfather, my grandfather was a very strong man. There was a photo of my grandfather, my opa, you know, carrying this big tree trunk, running down, looking dead happy. And that really kind of stuck with me. You know, that kind of ingrained the way to become one of the strongest men in the world. Since I was 18 years old, I've been involved in the oil and gas industry, which, you know, takes me all over the world, working in the sea, in the middle of the sea, working on these oil rigs. It's been a little bit of a slower start, I think, in my strongman career. So thankfully, I managed to give that up towards the end of last year through sponsorships and through the kind of financial backing from a few sponsors, which has been so, so massive. So now I'm pretty much a full-time strongman, and I think I'm starting to see the benefits of it now. So since I've stopped working on the oil rigs, you know, my strength has grown massively, which has been huge. The real highlight for me was last year when in World's Strongest Man, making history with my brother Tom to be the first brothers in history to make the final, to be the top 10 in the world. Making those historic things is something that no one can ever take away from us. Finishing second last year in Dubai in the world's ultimate strongman, you know, in such a stacked lineup. You know, we had basically the best guys in the world there, and to finish second just behind Mateusz was pretty cool. Being able to, you know, do these record attempts, hopefully I can surpass last year by hitting this 230 kilo log today, and, you know, it's going to be pretty special when I do. So obviously as strongmen, you know, we all have goals, and we all have kind of our sights set on the so-called record. So for me, the kind of top three is to be the best log presser that's ever been. I know that's a massive ask of myself, because Zadrinus for me is always going to be the GOAT. You know, he's the daddy when it comes to log press. So if I can at least be half as great as he was, then I think I'm doing okay. Secondly is to push on and win the big shows. You know, win World's Strongest Man, that's a goal. We're not there. I think Tom said it last year, we're not here to take part, we're here to take over. And certainly that's what we're aiming to do, you know, in the next couple of years, is really push on and set the Stoltman name, you know, create that legacy. When people in Scotland or throughout the world say Stoltman, that's what they think of. It's the world's strongest men. And that's something that I really want to kind of make happen. I think number three, you know, would be to try and help the next batch of people coming through, certainly in the Highlands. You know, we've got a lot of untapped potential, I think, with the local youth. You know, there's a lot of big guys, a lot of strong people in the Highlands. We've got a gym here, so if we could help them, encourage them to be the next, you know, half Thor, or Brian Shaw, Tom Stoltman, or myself, then, you know, we're doing something right. So it's always about the next kind of batch of the next generation. So guys, here we are. D-Day, 230 kilos, heaviest log in history. I'm just a little guy from the Highlands of Scotland. You know, I didn't think, looking back 10 years, I didn't ever think this was possible to be here in front of you guys, the millions of people watching. Anything is achievable, you know, it really is. So I think I'm, you know, the proof in the pudding. You know, I'm sitting here just about to press or try to press a 230 kilo log. So for anyone that doesn't think whatever your dreams or goals aren't possible, it's, you know, just to smash down those boundaries, because as soon as you believe something is possible, you'll just keep pushing on. And it's just never take no for an answer, guys. It's really believe in yourself, and that's what I've done these last couple of years, is really believe in myself and try to achieve the impossible.